one of the things I really like about the TF series is the customising options with these user-defined knobs and the user-defined keys up here. I'll let Steve talk you through those a bit.
Okay, what we've got here is, obviously, there is lots of stuff on the TF that you might want to adjust on a regular basis. So some of those things aren't instantly easy to find. So what we've got is a bunch of keys and controls here that we can assign a specific use to. For example, if you were always riding the input gain on a specific channel, then instead of finding that specific channel and having it on your screen, you could actually assign a control to do that. I mean, these four at the moment I've got assigned to various different things. One of them I've got assigned to actually screen brightness. So you can actually adjust the screen brightness. But you can see on here I've also got EQ frequencies, input gain for a specific channel, and EQ gain. So you can set the user-defined knobs to be incremental control for any element that you might want to adjust. So like saying, if you were always riding the input gain for a certain thing, you could assign that to here and you've got it instantly to control. The other user-defined controls are user-defined keys, and these are more global. You can assign these keys to make global changes. I mean, the obvious one is to change setups or scenes. So if you're doing a gig, you're doing sound at a gig and you've got four different bands on, then you get your presets for band one and you get them sounding good and you save that as a scene. So the scene memory here has 200 locations. So you can store up to 200 scenes, and that includes all your input gain, your EQs, your compression, the color of your channel strip, the names, everything. Yeah. Your monitor sends, all of that stuff. But changing it, you could go into the library, you could find it, and you can load it from there. Or if you're going to do it quickly, you can just use a user-defined key, and that will completely change the setup.
I've never thought of it in terms of changing scenes. You know, if you were doing a sound for a number of acts in an evening and you'd done sound checks earlier in the night and saved them, I never thought of using it like that, but that's quite a cool way.
It's just very quick to do it. You can change the entire configuration. You can also do this within a scene. If you've got a song, say, a ballad, where there's just the keyboard player and the singer, you could mute all your drums and your guitars, save that as a scene, and then just go from one song to the next that quickly. I mean, you could see how quickly it changes the entire lineup of the desk. So, and that obviously could include different reverb settings or different delays. So you can use the user-defined controls to make changes quickly, easily, and with your presets and your memory globally.
Okay.
Just by doing those. There's a couple of other functions as well that are kind of more dedicated. We've got a couple of USB ins here. You can see this is an iPad one. And so this is an input specifically for an iPad in order to play music from an iPad or iPhone. It's the Apple TFI protocol. Okay. So when you put your iPad in here, you can use it as a separate stereo input. That's just one input, completely controlled from the iPad, independent from all of these. These two here are also stereo RCA inputs on the back. So anything like mini disc or CD or whatever, you can play from here and control the level from here. And obviously, saving your scenes is going to store the level information as well, and any monitor information. This USB input here can be used for making a live recording on a USB stick. So if you want to record the gig in stereo, you use the USB stick in here, and that will record the entire gig to USB.
So does that mirror the master?
Just the main stereo out, absolutely. Okay. We'll cover the multi-track recording separately. Yeah. But basically, these extra inputs and extra features here will give you a sort of an ability to make very specific and personal changes to the desk.
Yeah.
The idea being that once you've loaded up your preset, your scene, you've got all the controls that you normally have quickly. This is kind of a customizable thing. On the group settings here, we've got 8 DCA fader groups. And so you can set up within your scene, you can set up DCA fader groups as well. So you've got 8, and it's really straightforward to do. When you go to your DCA, when you select it, you'll get a little display here with all of your inputs. And in order to assign them to a channel, as you can see here, my DCA one, I've got the drums. I could actually make that a different group. Say I want that to be my my vocal group.
Yeah.
I just select vocal here, and you can see now DCA one, and these are my vocals, and these are the volume levels within that group.
Within the group, okay.
Okay. But I'll go back to doing the drums one, because that was my drum one, so here we go. And there are 8 DCA fader groups, and you can assign anything to anyone. If I want DCA fader group 6 to be my keyboard group, I've only actually got one keyboard input, but if I had more, I could assign them, and that would be my keyboard group. So along with the user-defined controls and user-defined knobs, DCA fader groups, again, give you that customized feel. So the desk is entirely how you want it to be. All the controls you need are where you put them, and all of the things that you normally, that you might want to alter quickly, are there, ready to go. If you like the mixer strip with the color coding on, again, you can customize that. So if my lead vocal here was called Dave, if I go to this little feature on the bottom of the channel strip, you can see there's a little name tag here, and I can just change that. And call it Dave. Dave's favorite color is blue, so I'll make him blue or pink or yellow. So again, Dave, as you can see now, says Dave, and he's gone orange. So again, all of these things are personal settings, which we can now save in your scene, and that will recall it every time you want it to. So along with user-defined keys, user-defined controls, colored and named strips, you can set up the desk however you want it, exactly how you want it.
Great. I think one of the things that when I'm speaking to customers who are talking about changing from an analog desk to a digital desk, it's things about their analog desk that they think they're going to miss, which you can kind of get there, you know, just by setting up a little sort of user-defined key to do a specific feature that maybe is not there, and that side of things.
Absolutely, yeah. It requires a leap into this.
Oh, definitely, yeah.
But once you've made it, you'll find that anything that you could do on your desk that you were comfortable with, you can set up on here and equally be as comfortable.
And it can be as simple or as complicated as you want it to be, as we've seen in the other the other videos with the one knob control and things like that. So, not too much of a leap, I don't think.
Good.